A recent study by Andrew Huberman's lab in Cell Report Medicine showed that a 5-minute daily breathwork routine or mindfulness meditation can improve mood and reduce anxiety. Furthermore, they showed that breathwork can improve mood and physiological arousal more than mindfulness meditation. And regarding breathwork method, they showed that physiological sighing is most effective when compared to box breathing or cyclic hyperventilation in improving mood and lowering respiration rate. For clarification, cyclic hyperventilation is more widely known as the Wim Hof Method breathing. In the study, it's slightly different than the Wim Hof Method breathing, but I will get to that later. So today I want to go over all of these practices so that you can test them out for yourself and see what works best for you. Before we go further, I want to say that this video has more of an educational character. And if you're into guided breathwork sessions, I have you covered. I have prepared 5 minutes of guided breathwork for each of these practices that you can download for yourself and follow along. So just follow the link in the description for that. Hey friends, my name is Kitaro and I'm a certified Wim Hof Method instructor. And if you're new here on my channel, I cover everything regarding breathwork, cold exposure, and movement-related topics. Let's first take a look at the differences between mindfulness meditation and breathwork in general. I personally don't put these two in the same bucket, because for me at least, they have two different goals. In breathwork, for example, I practice a specific breathing pattern to influence my state to be more relaxed, more focused, or energized. In meditation, on the other hand, I work with my awareness or with my introspection and proprioception, to use some fancier words. My goal here is to be more aware of just being and dissecting and exploring my mind and body. So I don't necessarily change my state in contrast to breathwork. Instead, I dissolve the boundaries between my state and the thing that I call self. This is of course a challenging but worthwhile pursuit for understanding yourself better, but maybe not too effective if only done for 5 minutes daily. So if your main goal is to be more relaxed and improve your mood, breathwork might be more effective, and that is what the study also showed. In Huberman's study in Cell Report, they analyzed 3 different breathwork methods. Cyclic hyperventilation, aka Wim Hof Method breathing, the box breathing method, and physiological sighing. So let's take a closer look at these. Box breathing is a simple yet systematic approach to working with your breath. In box breathing, you control 4 parts of your breath. The inhale, the hold on full lungs, the exhale, and the hold on empty lungs for a specific duration. For example, I inhale for 4 seconds, hold for 4 seconds, exhale for 4 seconds, and hold again for 4 seconds. That's why the name box breathing. If possible, I would breathe entirely through the nose, and I would repeat this process for 5 minutes. I also try to not alter the time of my inhale, exhales, and holds. I can use a so-called CO2 tolerance test to determine a good time for my breaths and holds. And for that, you would need a timer. You first take 4 deep breaths. An in and exhale is 1 breath. And after the last inhale, you exhale as slowly as possible and time your exhale without pausing. And when my lungs are empty, I stop my time and I have the CO2 discard time. Now, if your CO2 discard time is 20 seconds or less, use a 3 to 4 second box breathing interval. If you have a discard time between 20 and 45 seconds, use a 4 to 6 second interval. And if your CO2 discard time is 45 to 75 seconds long, use an 8 to 10 second box breathing interval. I find box breathing a nice way to learn to control my breaths and my holds. Being able to combine inhale, exhales, and breath holds in a very simple and periodic way helps me to calm down. I sometimes use it to calm myself down during an ice bath, or especially during a longer ice bath when I want to forget about time. So while doing the box breathing, it's very easy to anchor my mind to this process and don't use up too much of cognitive resources. Cyclic hyperventilation or the Wim Hof Method breathing. The Wim Hof Method breathing is a simple but yet still a more elaborate way to work with your breath. It contains the following elements: 30 to 40 deep and strong hyperventilation-like breaths where you emphasize on the inhale and let the air escape for the exhale, followed by a breath hold on empty lungs combined with the body scan and deep relaxation. Then when you urge to breathe, you take a deep inhale and hold that inhale for 15 seconds. And after that, you exhale and the next round is going to start. Even though the Wim Hof Method breathwork protocol is quite simple, the practice itself is deep, and there are many fields where you can improve within this breathwork protocol. I have a video dedicated to the most common mistakes when doing the Wim Hof Method breathwork, so check that out if you're interested after this video. So the bottom line is that the practice itself takes a lot of work and it's not quite easy. This, I find, a minor flaw in Huberman's study design, as the intervention group for the cyclic hyperventilation group was very minimally trained. That said, the cyclic hyperventilation with retention differed from the Wim Hof Method breathwork in some points. For example, the intervention group were instructed to only do a 15-second breath holds on empty lungs. And also the protocol didn't have the 15 seconds breath hold on full lungs or the recovery breath after the retention phase. So looking at the study design, there was clearly a focus on the hyperventilation and therefore emphasis on the sympathetic nervous system, or our stress system, or our fight and flight mode. So it doesn't really surprise me that it would have less of a relaxing effect without a longer breath hold phase, where we engage the parasympathetic system or our rest and recovery mode. Cyclic sighing, or the physiological sigh. In the cerebral medicine study, the cyclic sighing method had the best results in improving mood and reducing respiration rate. Cyclic sighing, or the physiological sigh as it's also called, is a very easy breathwork method where you take a deep inhale followed by a second shorter inhale and a long exhale. And the duration of the exhale is about twice as long as the two inhales combined. So you have clearly an emphasis on the exhale. By emphasizing more on the exhale, we continuously engage the parasympathetic nervous system that lowers our heart rate and helps us to relax and mentally recover. The simplicity of physiological sighing and the strong engagement of the parasympathetic nervous system makes this breathwork method perfect for a 5-minute session if you want to calm down, relax, and reduce stress. I use the physiological sigh for various situations throughout the day. For example, I do the physiological sigh for 2 to 5 minutes. That could be between sets of strength exercises or also cognitive demanding working bouts. But I also use it if I want to sleep, but some stressful things keep me up at night. On the other hand, I wouldn't do the physiological sigh in the morning because at this time I want to be more energized and focused, and my main goal is not to calm down. So I would rather do a Wim Hof Method breathing session in the morning to get more agitated, for example. Integration and conclusion. In conclusion to these breathwork and meditation practices in regard to the Huberman lab study, I want to highlight that these practices are neither exclusive nor a one-size-fits-all solution. This is the reason why I encourage you to try them out, to see what suits you best and not just go for the physiological side just because the study showed that it brings the best results. What I enjoy practicing and what I find necessary to devote time and energy to master may differ from your journey also. And that's very important. If you understand the physiology of the breathwork methods, you can adapt them to your own needs. For example, I can use the Wim Hof Method breathing as a foundation to get into a deep meditative state and then follow up with my own meditation practice. Or I can use the knowledge behind the physiological sigh to steer my Wim Hof Method breathwork into a calmer tone if I if my anxiety, for example, rises too much from too strong hyperventilation, where I engage my sympathetic nervous system. So if you want to know more about the physiology of breathwork and what happens in the body, then be sure to check out this video here. As always, thanks for watching and see you in my next video. Bye.